I have now the honor to invite His Excellency Norbert Bartle, Parliamentary State Secretary of Ministry for Economic Cooperation and Development of Germany, to deliver an address.
So thank you, Chair. Distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to thank UNDRR for its great job in convening the sixth global platform. And I would like also to thank the Swiss government for hosting this important conference. For my government, the German government, this global platform is of enormous importance. We want to engage in fruitful discussions on coherence between global agendas, learning from each other, improving disaster risk management, including in fragile and conflict-affected contexts, disaster risk financing and all early warning, early action, better protection for disaster displaced persons, and strengthening the local level and especially civil society organizations to leave no one behind. These topics are key for the German government, and they are crucial for the successful implementation of the Sendai framework. The significance of the Sendai framework for national implementation lies in its clearly defined goals: reducing disaster risk, preserving lives, health and livelihoods, and protecting society and communities against extensive damage. For Germany, the Sendai framework still represents both a challenge and an opportunity. Germany already has an effective civil protection system, which pursues an integrated approach and includes a wide range of administrative levels, institutions, and actors. We would like to pool our knowledge and experience because we consider disaster risk reduction as a cross-cutting issue. Germany continues to be strongly committed to support disaster risk reduction worldwide through bilateral and multilateral partnerships, both in the humanitarian and in the development field. Coherence between the Sendai framework, the Paris Agreement, and the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development is of eminent importance to effectively strengthen resilience. In line with the core responsibilities of the Agenda for Humanity, we further strengthen local preparedness capacities and invest according to risks. Last year, we supported our humanitarian partners with more than 26 million euros for DRR efforts. Additionally, Germany has established a global initiative on disaster risk management to support partners in promoting practical agenda coherence. By 2020 already, more than half of the world's extremely poor will live in environments affected by disaster risks and conflict, fragility, and violence. We need to prioritize action in these contexts. Germany promotes disaster risk reduction in fragile and conflicted affected contexts as a viable approach to reduce vulnerability and support peace building, among other things in cooperation with the Global Facility for Disaster Reduction and Recovery of the World Bank. Germany also remains a committed partner for UNDRR. We support UNDRR in creating synergies between the climate and disaster communities. We are proud to have the Sendai monitoring team in Bonn. We value the Global Assessment Report on Disaster Risk Reduction and the innovative Global Risk Assessment Framework, to which we contribute as well. And ladies and gentlemen, let us not forget the pressing issue of climate change and the increased intensity and frequency of disasters. The international community needs to better address the protection needs of people displaced by disasters and the adverse effects of climate change, as underlined in the Global Compact for Migration. The integration of disaster displacement must become a priority in regional and national DRR plans. Climate change causes growing needs. We have increased our engagement within our humanitarian assistance for anticipatory risk financing approaches in order to enable more effective early action within the humanitarian system. Through the Insular Resilience Global Partnership, backed by German Development Cooperation, vulnerable countries are supported as they prepare financially for the impacts of disasters. The partnership connects more than 60 members, including the private sector, and is planned to provide climate risk insurance to 400 million poor and vulnerable people by 2020. Finally, let me underline the importance of local action. Risk reduction strategies can only be successful if communities are engaged and empowered. We need stronger support to communities in general and civil society organizations in particular. They have a specific understanding of local needs and give a voice to marginalized people. We must reach those who are most in need. Leaving no one behind is a guiding principle of German humanitarian assistance and development cooperation. No single player can reduce risks and build resilience alone. We need strong partnerships globally, regionally, and locally. Only a whole-of-society approach and multilateral partnerships will lead us to a resilient world. Let us all work for that. Thank you very much.